six technical moves, laying the law down and taking the rest of the kids to school.
Davey just had an amazing first run. It's like you just stepped the whole comp up right there.
I was pretty psyched. I stayed on my bike and my run flowed, so I was pretty psyched on it.
Here's a little explanation how bike stunt street works. We got 10 competitors, 75 second runs. You get an average of 2 runs on the 100 point scale. Well, here's a guy you don't normally see in the street final. It's Bird Dog, Jamie Beswick. Starting this run off with a bang right here with a big turn down back flip, or as Steve likes to call it, the Larry Loop.
Yeah, Jamie. And showing you he's got some street tech also. Grind to the boomerang grind, sliding all the way down.
Yeah, really enjoying myself today. Just gave me a break from Bert. You know, I ride a lot of street at Woodward and Jump Box, and I figured, you know, that's all this street course is, you know. I don't consider myself a street rider, but it's just a jump course, and, you know, with grind boxes, so I ride that stuff every day, so why not have a go?
Well, up next, we got a newcomer here to the finals, Bruce Chrisman.
20 years old out of Tigard, Oregon, riding for Haro Bikes.
Had some huge runs in the prelims, and he's coming out on fire once again.
And his good friend Robin Miller has just informed me that this is his first time ever in the finals. The huge truck driver over the spine for you.
Seriously,
place, tons of speed. Check this out.
Giant tail whip transfer. Oh, just can't quite hang on to it right there. Definitely one of the biggest transfers of the whole contest. There's another one right here.
Amazing height. Super pump, we like to call it, out of that transition.
Had a good run, was using the whole course, but just had one too many falls.
Definitely going to hear a lot more out of Ruben later on this year. An amazing rider.
Well, here's how we stand so far. We got a pretty tough class going on right now. Dave Asato still hanging on to that first place, though. Jamie Ron right behind him.
ESPN.
Welcome back to Bike Street. This is how we stand so far after a couple of serious runs and a couple of injuries as well. Up-and-coming young pro Josh Hino talking about his knee.
Just kind of a little freak accident. I just stepped off my bike and ended up just exploding my knee. Did my ACL, PCL, meniscus, you name it. Fractured a couple bones. Just got really unlucky. It's unfortunate for me. I was feeling really good. I made the cut at the last contest, and I was just, you know, felt pretty competitive. So it's a real letdown for me.
It's really too bad for Josh, but I guarantee we will see him back again. Next up, we have Rob Nolly. Putting in some huge runs.
Smooth rider, a lot of technicality, also has some big tricks as well, like this giant Superman transfer on the wedge into the bar spin.
And likes to finish big time.
Crowd wondering how he pulled that off. I think Rob's wondering how he pulled that off right there.
Troy McMurray ready to rip it up. Out there having a good time in Louisville.
Can't quite hang on right there to the bar spin coming down to Fakey.
Buckle your helmet, Troy. Troy doesn't care. Doesn't wear any elbow pads or knee pads. He's just ready to rock.
Always playing to the crowd, giving his helmet to a well-deserving fan here.
Troy, last year you got the Toughest Nails Award. And you're not riding any pads. It's like you have built-in pads.
Toughest nails, what can you do? I don't know. I don't know. You could be as tough as a nail all you want, but when you wreck and it hurts, it still hurts. Pads or no pads. I don't think there's pad bones for ribs. I mean, pads for the rib bones. So, unless I had the gladiator suit on, maybe, you know, but it's not my style, so.
Well, I mentioned earlier, fresh faces in the finals. Here's another one, 18-year-old Alan Cook. This guy was going nuts in the prelims.
This guy was blazing all over the street course, high-powered rider. Huge jumps. Nice variety over the entire course. Check this out, tons of speed. Big no for the can transfer from Allen. Definitely going to see more of this guy in the finals.
And that's going to bring up Dave Asato for run number two. His first run was amazing. Used the whole course, flowed everything. Let's see what he's got for run number two.
Raising it up and throwing it down.
More bike stunt street action. This is how we stand. curious to see if some of these new guys can come up and edge him out of his spot.
And one of the young guns, Seth Kimbrough, making it into the finals as of recent. Going for the 180 alley-oop slide down the ledge. I think he really wants this one pretty bad. And there he goes, sticking it second time.
Tell us what you did on the ledge right behind us.
180, 50-50. I don't know, I had to stick it. I don't know, it's just one of those mental things, I guess.
Well, that brings back Bruce Crispin for run number two after a very solid outing his first time up.
Going all over the street course, a lot of unique lines, back-to-back tricks all over the place, no blank walls for Bruce. Every time he touches the ramp, he's throwing something down.
Giant 360 over the spine here to the bar spin.
Mr. Crispin putting in a fine performance.
Speaking of fine performances, we're back with our first place vert finisher, Jay Miron.
Jay Miron on top of the list. Some familiar faces in there, and Seth Kimbrough in fifth place right now.